Kathleen Carnali here, and I am so excited to study the Word of God together, beginning in the incredible book of James. When I first came to Christ, this is one of the first books of the Bible that I actually read, and it soon became one of my favorites. It's so practical, and being new in the Word, all I wanted to know was how to love and serve God more. And now, being in Christ quite some time, this is still my ultimate goal. So you may be wondering who I am. A little bit about myself. I've been blessed to spend my life traveling full-time across the United States and around the world, ministering through song and word. I am married to an amazing man of God, and we now have three little ones that tour with us. You can watch some of our crazy, awesome travel adventures on our Carnali Crew channel if you want to check that out. And as for my music, you may have heard it already, but I'll be sure to share it as I open and close the studies. So let's fast forward to when COVID hit. That's when our whole world changed. Life and ministry on the road as we knew it came to a stop. It was definitely a be still and know that He is God moment, which I think probably most of us can relate with. So I quickly released a song and video called 2020 Strangely Dim to help bring hope and light through such a dark and confusing time. But I still had this deep burden to share the written and spoken word of God. That's what I would often do at my live events along with the music. And I felt like that's what was missing. I was reminded of a promise that the Lord gave me a while back, and I knew that it was time to step out in obedience and start studying the scriptures verse by verse so that others at home could study with me. And now I am thrilled to be here with Hope on Demand to study God's word together and hopefully teach you to compare scripture with scripture, to read and comprehend His word, and of course, share it with others. The Bible says that in the beginning was the Word, and the Word was with God, and the Word was God. So the more we know and receive of His Word, the more we can know who Jesus is. The Bible says to renew our minds and to study to show ourselves approved. So let's start the book of James today. Are you ready? Go grab your Bible, maybe a notebook, a pen, or a pencil, and I am going to open us up with my uke and a chorus.
Be prepared to live like you've never lived before. Leave the past that binds you. You were meant to soar. Step beyond the shadows of what you used to know. There's a whole new world before you. Let the old one go. Yeah. Just live. Just live. You were meant to live. Yeah. You were meant to live. Just live.
Thank you for your truth, God. Thank you for your word. Renew our minds in you this morning. We give you all the glory and praise forever. In Jesus' name, amen. So open your Bible with me to the book of James, and let's start in verse 1. James, a servant of God and of the Lord Jesus Christ, to the 12 tribes which are scattered abroad, greeting. So can I just start with saying, I love how people started letters back then. I mean, the Apostle Paul does the same thing where he starts with his name, and we see James. I love that because nowadays, what do? We end our letters with our name, which to be honest, we don't really write letters as much anymore. But when we write something out, we usually sign our name at the bottom. And it really provides an awful context because you sometimes have to go to the end of your letter to see who wrote it before you actually read it. So you have a context of who is speaking. Which brings us to our next question. Who is James? Well, we see a few Jameses in scripture, right? We know there is James, the brother of John, the son of Zebedee. There is also James, the son of Alphaeus. And could one of them have written this letter? There is that possibility. However, when you really look into it and look into history, we realize that the consensus is this is James, the brother of Jesus. And when I say brother, I mean physical brother. Obviously not with Joseph as their father, but with Mary as their mother. So I guess we would call him a younger half-brother of Jesus. So though James grew up with Jesus and obviously knew he was an incredible healer, a teacher, it is believed that he accepted Jesus as Messiah after he encountered the resurrection. Just another reminder of how powerful and important that resurrection of Christ is for all of us, So James, at the time that this letter was written, was a very well-known leader in Jerusalem. He was highly respected by the Jewish followers of Christ, and he had great influence. So we see here that James is writing to the 12 tribes scattered abroad and to those who have put their trust in Yeshua as Messiah, who have made Jesus Christ their Lord. So really, you guys, this letter applies to anyone who calls him Lord. But if you're sitting here right now watching this video and you say, you know what? I know about Jesus. And like James, I believe that he was a good teacher and an amazing healer. But maybe you haven't yet encountered the resurrection in your own life, or maybe you have not yet made him Lord of all. Well, the time for that is right now. Romans chapter 10, verse 9 says that if thou shalt confess with thy mouth the Lord Jesus and shall believe in thine heart that God hath raised him from the dead, thou shalt be saved. For with the heart man believes unto righteousness, and with the mouth confession is made unto salvation. So confess him as Lord. Jesus Christ is Lord. And as we continue in this study in the weeks ahead, we're going to realize that there are many Jewish believers and then there are many Gentile believers. And the Jewish believers already knew the scriptures and so much of the tradition. And yet the Gentiles, they came from a background of false gods and idolatry, or maybe even believing in nothing at all. The point here is that we are all on the same playing field when it comes to Jesus. The Bible says he's no respecter of persons. He died to save all of us, no matter if you have a religious background or not. He is the one that looks straight into the heart. He is the one that calls you by name. It doesn't matter where you came from or what you've done. The blood of Christ was shed for you and for me. Verse 12 says, for there is no difference between the Jew and the Greek, for the same Lord over all is rich unto all that call upon him. For whosoever shall call upon the name of the Lord shall be saved. So I encourage you to stick with me during these studies and grow in the grace and knowledge of our Lord, increasing our faith and learning what it is to walk in his spirit. Just a few verses down in verse 17, says, so then faith cometh by hearing, and hearing by the word of God. So lend your ear and tune in to God's word, that we may walk by faith and not by sight. So for now, I send all my love, and I so look forward to next week already. I'll be right here, same time, same place, with my uke and study, and we will dive into God's word together. See you soon.
Be prepared to live like you've never